Good morning students. In today's class we are going to discuss about spermatogenesis. In the last class itself we had a discussion on human male reproductive system structure and TS of testis. You could remember that within the TS of testis, within the testis we have a several testicular lobules. These testicles, inside the each and every testicular lobule, several 1, 2, 3 seminiferous tubules are there, right? 1, 2, 3 seminiferous tubules, I said. These seminiferous tubules are lined by a germinal epithelium which is formed of two types of cell. One is germ cell and another one is Sertoli cell, isn't it? One is germ cell and another one is Sertoli cell. This germ cell, what is the role of the germ cell? Which is only for spermatogenesis. And the Sertoli cell is providing nourishment. Outside the seminiferous tubule, you see here, this is one seminiferous tubule and this is another seminiferous tubule. In between the seminiferous tubule, we have a space that is nothing but interstitial space. This interstitial space which contains Leydig cells. What is the role of Leydig cell? Leydig cell role is providing, secreting male hormone known as testosterone, which is the best example, comes under androgen. Am I right? Can you remember all these things? So about this, if you could remember this, it is easy for us to learn the spermatogenesis. You see here, I have given a cross section of a seminiferous tubule. Again, within this single seminiferous tubule, we have a violet color structure, you know, that is nothing but a germ cell. And here and there in between this, we have a green color cells that is nothing but Sertoli cells. Outside the green color cell, you see Leydig cells are there, which is pinkish in color. Leydig cell I have mentioned. See, Sertoli cell and germ cells are present within the seminiferous tubule. Outside the seminiferous tubule, that means in between the seminiferous tubule, we have a Leydig cells. So if you are clear about this, it is easy for us to learn the spermatogenesis. What are all the hormonal role? How come hormone is playing a role in spermatogenesis? Before going in detail, we must learn about this. You see, hypothalamus. You all know hypothalamus is a master of master gland. This hypothalamus is releasing GnRH. What is GnRH? Which is gonadotropin releasing hormone. This gonadotropin releasing hormone induces anterior pituitary. Anterior pituitary is nothing but adenohypophysis. This anterior pituitary produces LH, that is luteinizing hormone, and FSH, which is follicular stimulating hormone. So these two hormones are released by anterior pituitary under the influence of gonadotropin releasing hormone, right? This luteinizing hormone induce the Leydig cell. Can you remember the Leydig cell now, where it is? In the interstitial space of the seminiferous tubule it is present. This Leydig cell secretes testosterone under the influence of LH, luteinizing hormone. In the same way, FSH, this follicular stimulating hormone, induces Sertoli cells, which are present within the seminiferous tubule. This Sertoli cell produces induces this germ cell to produce spermatogenesis for the production of sperm. That process is called spermatogenesis. At the same time, this Sertoli cell, which releases another hormone called inhibin. You see, this mechanism is showing very clearly, it is showing very clearly that your LH is inducing Leydig cell to produce testosterone. This testosterone sometime can induce the Sertoli cell for the production of spermatogenesis as well as inhibin hormone. At the same time, follicular stimulating hormone of anterior pituitary also induces Sertoli cell to release inhibin as well as involving spermatogenesis. Suppose testosterone role is have higher in your bloodstream. What happens? Automatically it affects the, it induces the hypothalamus and stop releasing gonadotropin releasing hormone. At the same time, this inhibin, which is secreted by the Sertoli cell, also inhibits your GnRH production by the hypothalamus. It's like a feedback mechanism. So under the hormonal control only, our human male reproductive system is functioning. This process will take place after puberty, right? வாட் ஆர் ஆல் த ஸ்டெப்ஸ் இன்வால்வ்டு, வாட் ஆர் ஆல் தியர் ஆர் த டூ மேஜர் ஸ்டெப்ஸ், ஒன் இஸ் ஃபார்மேஷன் ஆஃப் ஸ்பெர்மேட்டட் அண்ட் அனதர் ஒன் இஸ் ஸ்பெர்மியோஜெனிசிஸ். ஒன் ஃபார்மேஷன் ஆஃப் ஸ்பெர்மேட்டட் இஸ் அ மேஜர் ஸ்டெப் அண்ட் செகண்ட் ஒன் இஸ் ஸ்பெர்மியோஜெனிசிஸ். தீஸ் டூ ஆர் த மேஜர் ஸ்டெப்ஸ் விச் ஆர் இன்வால்வ்ட் இன் ஸ்பெர்மட்டோஜெனிசிஸ். அண்டர் ஃபார்மேஷன் ஆஃப் ஸ்பெர்மேட்டட் தெர் ஆர் த்ரீ மேஜர் ஃபேஸஸ் ஆர் தேர். ஒன் இஸ் மல்டிப்ளிகேட்டிவ் ஃபேஸ், திஸ் மல்டிப்ளிகேட்டிவ் ஃபேஸ் இஸ் அதர்வைஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் மைட்டாட்டிக் ஃபேஸ். அண்ட் செகண்ட் ஒன் இஸ் க்ரோத் ஃபேஸ் அண்ட் தேர்ட் ஒன் இஸ் மெச்சுரேஷன் ஃபேஸ். மெச்சுரேஷன் ஃபேஸ் இஸ் அதர்வைஸ் கால்ட் மியாட்டிக் ஃபேஸ். Can you get my point? Multiplicative phase is nothing but mitosis. You know well, mitosis is nothing but multiplicative division and meiosis is reduction division. So, multiplicative phase is otherwise called mitotic phase and second one is growth phase, third one is maturation phase or meiotic phase. What happens? I have given a schematic representation of the spermatogenesis. You know well that inside the seminiferous tubule we have a germ cell. I have said already the role of germ cell is production of sperm, isn't it? Involved in the spermatogenesis. That germ cell forms a large number of rounded spermatogonial cell. Round shaped spermatogonial cell. See, this is your round shaped spermatogonial cell. This spermatogonial cell is otherwise called primary sperm mother cell. Spermatogonial cell is otherwise called primary sperm mother cell. Some of the primary sperm mother cell or spermatogonial cell undergoes repeated mitosis and acts as a stem cell. It acts as a stem cell as there is no menopause in human male, you know well. So, that cells I have denoted here as A, type A spermatogonium. Got it? And what is this type B spermatogonium? Some spermatogonium or primary sperm mother cell move inward and involve in the growth phase. They are called type B spermatogonium. Can you get my point? Germ cell forms a large number of rounded spermatogonial cells or primary sperm mother cell through mitosis. Right? They are diploid in nature. So, some spermatogonial cells undergo repeated mitosis and acts as a stem cell. As there is no menopause in human male, they are denoted here as a type A spermatogonium. And some spermatogonial cells move inward and involve in the growth phase. They are called as type B spermatogonial cell. Are you clear? Up to this is known as multiplicative phase. Up to this type B spermatogonium I mentioned, right? That is nothing but multiplicative phase or mitotic phase. So far, you are diploid in nature. They are diploid in nature, right? What happens? This spermatogonium, type B spermatogonium, enter into growth phase and it increases its size. The size of the, what is the difference between type B spermatogonium and this primary spermatocyte? Size is increased. How come it is increased? With the nutrition. It fills accumulation of the nutrition. And replication of DNA also takes place here. And it forms diploid primary spermatocyte. Diploid, your primary spermatocyte is also diploid in nature. Got it? So, primary spermatocyte formation is nothing but growth phase. Before that is nothing but maturation phase. Are you clear? This primary spermatocyte enters into maturation phase. That last third one I said, right? That is nothing but maturation phase. Yeah, so through meiosis 1, the primary spermatocyte produces two spermatocytes, that is secondary spermatocytes, one primary spermatocyte, diploid primary spermatocyte, through meiosis 1 produces two secondary spermatocytes. They are haploid in nature. Then these two secondary spermatocytes again and undergoes meiosis 2 and produces four haploid spermatids. Got it? And it produces four haploid spermatids. Up to this is nothing but formation of spermatid. I said two major steps. One is formation of spermatid and another one is spermiogenesis. So up to this is nothing but formation of four spermatid is nothing but formation of spermatids. Now it enters into spermiogenesis. This spermatid mature into spermatozoa. spermatid mature into spermatozoa, where it takes place in the cytoplasm of the Sertoli cell. Are you clear? So the green color cell which I have shown earlier in the seminiferous tubules cross section, that is nothing but Sertoli cell. Within the Sertoli cell only, maturation of the spermatid into spermatozoa taken place. So the transformation of non-motile, you see these four spermatids are non-motile in nature, they are round in shape. So non-motile rounded haploid spermatid into a functional motile spermatozoa, is nothing but spermiogenesis. Are you clear? So here two major steps, as I said, one is formation of spermatid and another one is spermiogenesis. What is spermiogenesis? Transformation of non-motile, rounded and haploid spermatid into functional and motile spermatozoa is called spermiogenesis, right? Then this mature spermatozoa, after this what happens? This mature spermatozoa gets released into the lumen of the seminiferous tubule. Now only it comes out from the Sertoli cell and it enters into the lumen of the seminiferous tubule. This process is known as spermiation. What is spermiation? The mature spermatozoa are released into the lumen of the seminiferous tubule is called spermiation. Right. Now, what is the structure of a single sperm? So, through spermiation, a mature spermatozoa enters into the lumen. What is the structure? How it will be? A mammalian sperm, it is a minute, microscopic, flagellated and motile gamete with no nutritive material, no protective envelopes, and most of the cell organelles, right? No ribosomes, no endoplasmic reticulum, etc. The complete body is covered by a plasma membrane. Basically, you see here, there are four regions. One is head region and a small neck region where centriole I mentioned, right? That is neck region. And third one is midpiece. Midpiece we call. And the fourth one is tail region. So, head region, neck region, midpiece or middle piece, at last tail region, right? What is special in head region? You see here in the head region, dark violet color structure, that is nucleus. Above the nucleus, anterior to the nucleus, we have a pointed edge, that is nothing but acrosome. What is special in acrosome? This acrosome is filled with hyaluronidase. What is hyaluronidase? It is a lytic enzyme. What is special in this? During the sperm entry, the acrosome secretes this enzyme which helps the penetration of ovum. At the time of fertilization, at the time of fusion of these two gametes, this acrosome plays a major role. Now come to neck region. It is a very smallest part. This neck region is a very smallest part of spermatozoa. It is formed of two centrioles. Here we have two centrioles. One is proximal centriole and another one is distal centriole. Proximal centriole is posterior to the nucleus. At the time of entry of sperm into the ovum, this proximal centriole also will enter along with the head region of the sperm into the ovum, which induces the cell division after the zygote formation. And then you come to midpiece. What is special about midpiece? We call midpiece as the powerhouse of a sperm, right? We call this as a powerhouse of the sperm. Why do we call this as a powerhouse of the sperm? Because which is completely filled with mitochondria. ATP synthesis can take place. At last, tail region, this is known as flagellum. What is the speciality about tail region? Which is the longest part of the sperm? Of course, your tail region is the longest part of the sperm. It is formed of two parts. Central contractile and microtubular part called axoneum or axial filament. Axial filament is there in the center. And outer protoplasmic sheath. What is the major function? This trail shows lashing movement which provide forward push to the sperm, right, which helps the sperm to move. That is the major role of the sperm. Children, so far we had a discussion about the cross section of a single seminiferous tubule and steps involved in the spermatogenesis, and third one, schematic representation of the spermatogenesis, and at last a structure of a simple one single sperm that we had discussed. So based on this, can you define now what is spermatogenesis? Spermatogenesis is the process by which a mature haploid spermatozoa develop from a germ cell in the seminiferous tubule of the testis. Do you have any doubt in this, children? If you have any doubt, please raise your doubts through my WhatsApp number or to my mail. Right, go through this along with this video. You will get few questions also. Try to answer. I'll add some class notes. Take down those notes in your notebook. Thank you.